You can't talk about the South and not talk about college football. You know, I don't think I've ever seen loyalty manifest itself any greater than it does when it comes a Southerner supporting his favorite college football team. Now, Bubba loves football. I do. I'm not much into pro football. I don't like perfection. I want to see the kid down the street, what I saw grow up, go on to college and do good. I am a college football fan. I don't like baseball. I think baseball's a socialist plot to try and ruin spring training. And I never have got into 7-foot guys running around in their underwear throwing a ball through a hoop. I just don't understand that. It's not a Bubba kind of thing. It don't matter where you went to school either. It doesn't matter if you went to school at the college of your choice, but you live in the South, you have got to choose a college. It is just like a law down here that you got to do that. You don't have to go to school there. If that was true, Alabama and Auburn could play in my living room. Now, Alabama is, in their defense, I will tell you, is the only state I've ever gone to where women understand football. They can tell you the history of the game. They know about the Bear. They know about Shug Jordan. They know who's the players on the team. And they have to be like that, or otherwise they couldn't talk to their brothers and fathers. I have discovered why they located that Mercedes-Benz plant over next to Tuscaloosa and University of Alabama. You know why that is? There's an overabundance of crash dummies there. Got some Alabama people here. I saw two Auburn guys on the beach last week after the hurricane. Came down there. I guess they, you know, I could tell they're from Auburn. They had orange and blue bathing suits on. They was on backwards. I guess they were used to the zipper being there. I don't know. You know. I could just tell they was Auburn boys. They standing out there and they'd obviously never seen the Gulf before. And one of them was standing there looking out over it and said, "Lord God, that's a lot of water." And the other said, "Yeah, and that's just the top of it." They were wild, man. It was unbelievable. I mean, you know, it's just something about it. Well, how about them dogs? Yeah. Some Georgia people here tonight. I love it when they're... I tell you, my most favorite thing about a Georgia game is when the opposing team cheerleaders run on the field and them boys in the end zone stand up and say, "How about them dogs?" Now, that is a special part of the game for me. I mean, you know, so, now I am a Florida State Seminole. We got any Seminoles here tonight? I am. I live in Northwest Florida. And you know, I have been a Seminole since we were 1-21. I am one of Bowden's boys. That's right. Now, somebody just said it out there, and that's absolutely true. I hate Gators. I wouldn't hit a hog in the butt with every Florida Gator I ever met. I don't like Gators. First one I ever met walked up and said, "What are you?" I said, "I'm a Seminole." He said, "You one of them half-ass Indians, a semi-hole." I said, "Well, I guess it's better to be half an ass than one entirely." I don't like Gators. Now, I'm one of Bowden's boys. Bobby Bowden is one of the God-fearing, Christian, fire, brimstone, spitting coaches that ever lived. He came to Florida State and turned things around totally. I mean, he was there. We were 1-21. We signed him up, took him outside of Tallahassee on the highway what runs through that town, and took a picture of him under a sign. It said, "Interstate 10, FSU, nothing." We gave him a bumper sticker that said "Beat anybody." We just didn't care who it was. Now we just don't beat anybody. I don't like Florida Gators. You know, Steve Spurrier's a coach down there. You know the only difference between Steve Spurrier and a newborn puppy? Sooner or later, the puppy stops whining. But chopping the air with tomahawk chops, Ole Miss Rebel flag, War Eagles, drunk Cajuns running around LSU, people dropping on the ground and barking like dogs at Georgia, just crazy. I mean, you got to love some team when you're down here. But the one what just blows my mind is the first time the University of South Carolina Gamecocks came on the field 4 years ago. NBC television. They are just running out there playing Rutgers. Running out there on the field, and when they ran out, all them people from Rutgers started hollering, to burying their children's head in the seat and closing their eyes because they had a big sign. I ain't making this up. Come running out. The cheerleaders had right across here said Cox. Had a big sign at the end of the field down there, said, "We love our Cox. You can't beat our Cox." And NBC got 500 calls in an hour from Northern people what don't understand what that is. So you got to be a Southerner to understand that. That's okay, and you don't, ain't nothing wrong with it. You got to understand what that is. I don't like Miami Hurricanes either. My manager, Steve Ennis of Miami, I hate him. Graduated from Miami. Once a year, I just get to hate him. And I have had several times watching the ball games with him. You can always tell them Miami people, though. We played him down there in the Orange Bowl once. Got through after the game, and FSU guys walking along the beach there wanting to do something. Had a couple of days left. He saw this sign at a travel agency. Said, $99 Gulf Cruise, 4 days, 3 nights. So he walked in. He said, "I think I'll take the $99 Gulf Cruise." Guy said, "Fine." Steps in the room, takes a baseball bat, whops him right in the head. Whop! Tied him in an inner tube, threw the back door open, and flopped him out there in the Gulf. He just bobbing around. A few minutes later, Miami Hurricane guy walked in. Said, "I think I'll take the $99 Gulf Cruise." Guy, same thing. Whop! Built him in the head, threw him in an inner tube. They flopped him out there in the Gulf, and they floating off down towards Key West. About 30 minutes later, they're bobbing up downside each other. Florida State guy looked over and said, "You think they're going to serve dinner on this cruise?" Miami guy said, "I don't think so. They didn't last year."